And welcome back to Everhood. We played a lot last time, and I don't know if we will be able to finish the route that we are currently on tonight, but I will try. Let's play some more of this game. I've been having a good time, and chat wanted me to do Genocide Route, so we are currently smack dab in the middle of Genocide Route. And it looks like we have to kill our best friend, Blue. That's where we last left off. Right before we kill Blue. Let's talk to him. I remember now. This is where we first met. Goldpig promised to make me taller if I stole your arm. But instead, that scum stole my legs. Soon I will forget about how I lost my legs. Then I will forget about you, Red. I know that no one can stop you. Right now, everything is so clear, but I think being in a world like this alone, not being able to remember anything, it just doesn't seem nice at all. It feels like there's something bigger going on here. Maybe like an important cause? Which is why I have something to tell you. Green Mage blocked the door to Midnight Town, but there is a hidden entrance. Green Mage told me to keep it hidden. I think Green Mage gave me this job because I would forget where it was, so it would remain hidden for everyone. I trust what you're doing, Red. Damn, he just showed me the door to Midnight Town, baby. Alright, pains me to do this, Blue. I have no choice. We gotta kill our boy. He was our best friend the whole game. Tragedy. Tragedy unfolds in Neverhood. I'm glad that I still remember you. Could I please tell you something? You haven't said a word during the time that we've known each other. You helped me even when I did something bad to you. Without you, I never would have made it to Goldpig's temple. You helped Flan in that game, even though they attacked you later. You helped Green Mage get their eye back. Maybe it was all just to get your arm back, I don't know. I think that I'm ready now. Damn, dude, the only two options are kill and kill. Shit. Well, we did it. We killed Blue. Alright. This is pretty much, if you guys have played Undertale, this next fight is like the equivalent of like Undyne the Undying. It's not the hardest fight in the game, but it's like up there. This is one of the hardest fights. Rossaby says, I won't allow you to go any further. Last time that you had your arm, so many perished. If anyone else dies, I just cannot stand by and watch it happen again. So now Rasta Beast is gonna try to take us down, dude. He's actually strong as shit. Alright, let's see if I still got it. 8 hours into the stream, let's see if I still got it. That was one of the hardest fights in the game. Well, it looks like I don't got it. Looks like I'm getting my ass whooped. I gotta focus. I've been playing Zelda and Mario all day. Now it's time for Everhood. I need to think in terms of Everhood. Shit. shit. This is the safest spot on the map, so I'm just gonna stay here. Die, die, die. Damn, he hates us now, bro. He's like, dude, you literally just kill everybody. He's trying to stop us. Shit. Are you serious, bro? I literally died there. Oh my gosh. And you have to kill him under a time limit, dude. If the song ends before you kill him, you lose. Shit, bro. I promise this is a lot harder than it looks. Because you have to like button time the counters just right. Fuck, dude, it's so hard to... How many more hits does it take, bro? Bro, oh my god, there's no way I'm killing this guy. There's no way I'm killing this guy, dude. It's hard. I gotta check something. Why is my phone blowing up with dumb shit? He's just like such a bullet sponge, you know? Like, I'm hitting him a lot, but he just has so much health for no reason that it just takes forever. More so than like almost any other boss in the game. Mm. Come on, he's got to die soon, right? Thank God. I got him. Suck on that one, Rasta Beast. You are strong. I tried my best to stop you, but it wasn't enough. Right, Sans? My genocide, boy. Alright, I'm gonna do a fat save after that so I never gotta fight that guy again. Ta-da. Keep it real, dude. Alright, up next, time to kill the trash can. Hey! You think you're tough coming in here and making a ruckus? I'll show you ruckus. Now we gotta kill the trash man. This fight's a lot easier than this than Ross would be, so we should be good. After this, though, it's like my third favorite boss fight in the whole game. It's one of the fan favorite boss fights, the Shopkeeper. It's got one of the best songs and best fights. So look forward to that. It's one of the best songs and best fights in the whole game, at right after this trash can, man. Right after we genocide route this guy. Look how much quicker his health goes down. No, I didn't kill him in time. It's timed. What game has my favorite boss fight ever? That's tough, actually. I'm trying to think of like one of my favorite bosses. I really do love a lot of the bosses of Metal Gear Rising. Final boss of Ocarina of Time is good if you include Human Ganon and then the Ganondorf and then the Ganon fight. I don't know. It's tough. The final boss of this game is definitely my top 10. I don't know where it would stack up, but it's definitely my top. The final boss of Genocide Route in this game, one of my favorite bosses ever. Shit. I want to retry just because, like, you have to make sure you land, like, every hit that you can. Come on, he's so close to dying, please! Gotcha, bitch! Gotcha, boy! Well, get out of town. And we're playing on hard mode, too. This game's no joke on hard mode. Even if I make it look easy, I promise you. Oh, not even my shell could protect me from you. I've waited a long time for this. Two. All right, here comes. Yo, thanks for the gifted sub. 15 more minutes to the timer. Oh shit. And hey, that actually, we actually broke our 50 sub goal. Now I gotta do You Laugh, You Lose tomorrow. Shit. We're doing genocide route. Welcome to Everhood. We're doing genocide route right now. Halfway to our goal. Well, now I gotta do You Laugh, You Lose. You're just in time for one of the best bosses in the game. Just in time for one of the best bosses in the game. Hold up, let me update the sub goal thing. Yeah, all of our parts are up on YouTube. This is only the third part, but it's like a cool Undertale inspired Guitar Hero game. Wait, unpin this. There we go. Okay. Alright, next sub goal, if we hit 60 subs, we'll be streaming many hours of Ocarina of Time Chaos Edition, the new one. The one that we saw from that trailer with, like, the Majora's Mask moon. Not the one that Andrew and I played years ago, the new one. 60 subs, Ocarina of Time Chaos Edition segment. Cool, cool. Yeah. Pretty much, if you want the story recap, we were playing as a character named Red. We're looking for our arm. We got our arm back. Found out that the world that we live in, Everhood, is actually purgatory. And the only way that the souls of those in purgatory can move on is if you kill them. We are the only ones capable of killing them and having their souls move on to the next life. So you can either choose to do pacifist run, which is to not kill anybody and allow them to remain in purgatory, or you can do genocide route where you kill everybody in purgatory so that they can all be freed. The problem is, not everyone wants to be freed. Yeah. We're freeing their souls, but not everybody wants to be freed, or not everybody knows that they're in purgatory. So they still see us as the villain. So, but the only way everybody can be freed is if we kill everybody. So now we gotta go in this store and kill the shopkeeper. This is one of my favorite bosses in the whole game, dude. The music's a banger. I'm gonna turn it up. What do you want to do? Let's talk to him first.
You seem interested in that chest. For you only, I'll tell. Only the brown mage can unlock the golden locks. So I've heard.
Kill him. You asking for trouble? No troublemaking in my shop. Alright, I'm a banger at this fight because it's one of my favorites and I've played it over and over again, so I'm about to make this look easy mode. You ready? Get your sour pleases ready. I don't have time for water. Here we go. One of the best bosses in the game. Probably my third favorite boss. Third favorite boss. You gotta dodge the notes or deflect them back. It's trippy, dude, because he's the flower shop owner, so he uses like trippy flower shit on you. Rest in peace, the bitrate. Dude, this game is so fucking good. It's one of the most underrated games I've ever played. I highly recommend our full playthrough on YouTube. Dude, I love this game, bro. It's so fun. I'm so goated. Maybe not. Don't die now. Oh shit, it's tilting the stage! That's why I said the final boss of Genocide Route is one of my favorite bosses in any video game ever. Don't die now, bro. Sorry, buddy, not today. Your soul is mine. Such a shame. I must file for bankruptcy. The sad thing, dude, he dies and all the flowers in his shop wilt. Oh, that's so depressing despite the laugh track that I just played. You kill him and all the flowers die too. Shit. I can turn the audio down now. I think I can open the... I can break the lock now. Ouch! Thanks for removing that lock. Green Mage locked me up to keep you away, I guess? No, not our fish, buddy. Hi there. I feel like I am destined to do great things in my lifetime. Well, yeah, like get killed by us. Sorry, bud. Hey, what are you doing? Bring me batteries and I will give you something special. Yes. Finally, I can power my toilet. Right, I promise you something. Yes, yes. A lava lamp, right? Oh no. I seem to have lost it. But if you bring me a trampoline, I can give you something. That's a super promise. Wait, hold on a minute. I've already given you a super promise. Forgive my thoughtless requests. I shall reward you greatly for your endeavors. I will need to open up the secret entrance to my keep. Okay. Please be very discreet. The secret entrance is located south of the pool of water. You will find a pile of rocks and a door. I've unlocked it for you. Aha! Please help me! I've been paralyzed for ages. The brown mage won't let me go. Yeah, that's kind of disturbing. Let's read this letter.
Dear Brown Mage, you never want to do anything lately. You just sit in your little hole and eat and eat and eat. There really isn't anyone on my level, and I am bored out of my mind. I might give the mushrooms a visit. And yes, I will be taking the ruby with me. Green Mage. Welcome, friend. I sadly have some bad news. I seem to have miscalculated my hypothesis. I need a very rare type of stick. Unless you have a special type of stick. Wait, you do? Give it to me and I will finish it. Finally, I give you this, as you've given me so much. The golden key. This key will unlock secrets.
Thank you. This crocodile was literally paralyzed for thousands of years, and he couldn't escape, but Brown Mage was just keeping him as a pet. So he literally, like, wanted us to kill him, which is really dark and twisted. But he, like, wanted, like, a mercy kill.
Hey, what did you do to my crocodile? I thought you were a friend. Why are you acting so hostile? What do you want? Wait. Oh no. I've been tricked. It's you. Even after everything I've done for you. Damn, we still killed him. Cold-hearted, bro. Cold-hearted.
Nobody's safe from our wrath. With a Grim Reaper. Hatch is shut tight. Do you want to open it with your arm?
Hey there, Red. I'm a bit embarrassed that you broke into my cellar.
Surprise, sorry.
But I guess I shouldn't be. Now, what is it that you want? I wouldn't go in there if I were you. That corridor is endless. Well, technically it isn't endless. There is an end. It will just take forever to get there. I know, because I made the corridor.
So here's a fun fact, chat. And I don't even know what's at the end of this corridor because I didn't look it up. One of these days I'll do it myself. But I didn't look it up. But there is a secret ending if you get to the end of this corridor. I don't know what it is. I don't know what happens. If there's a boss. I don't know nothing. All I know is to get to the actual end of this corridor, you have to walk to the right for 3.5 in-game hours. Isn't that crazy? You literally need to just hold right. Go to all the rooms for 3.5 hours, and that's how you get to the end of the corridor. And it actually leads to a secret ending of the game, but I've never done it because I never really wanted to waste my time pressing right for 3.5 hours. Maybe one day I will. Maybe one day I'll just have this set up, and I'll have, like, YouTube or whatever. Like, I'll watch, like, a YouTube video, and we'll just go to the end of the corridor. But I'm not doing that today. But, yeah, there's legitimately a 3.5 hour walk to a hidden ending. Which is kind of crazy. But I've never done it, so.
So this is it. This is where it ends. After spending an eternity in Mushroom Forest. How anticlimactic.
Wait! Stop. You're serious. Hear me out.
If you want a true clash of life and death, we'll have to spice it up. Come into my playroom.
What's going on, Reb? I know you can't hear me, but thanks. I hope that you're having fun.
A straw doll with a gray wizard hat.
Hi there, buddy. Do you want to save?
Why, yes, I do.
Great. Good luck.
I'll kill the save point after I talk to this guy. Let's read this thing.
The main reason why I gave the ruby to you is to have them separated. Together, they are too powerful in the wrong hands. The emerald is locked inside an indestructible chest stored with an acquaintance of mine. For your own sake, I won't tell you where the aquamarine is located. Take good care of yourself, Green. Brown Mage.
Welcome to my real playroom.
Only a special few know of its existence. Let us not delay the inevitable, or are you scared that you might lose?
I'm killing you, boy.
I must be honest. I haven't felt this alive in a long time.
No problem, dude. It looks like we only have a little over an hour, so... Not too bad, not too bad. Ugh. Give me your best, Red.
I don't remember if this guy is really hard or not.
Also, you can't deflect black notes, so if you're wondering why I'm not deflecting those, you can't.
Let's ramp it up a little bit.
Oh my gosh, I can barely see, bro. Holy hell.
Dude, it's so hard to hit him because he's always, like, throwing so much out that it just, like, deflects my attacks.
I like the disco lights. He's going hard in this final battle against Green Mage. Shit, dude, his lightning is strong as hell. I hate the stupid wiggly attacks, bro. Dude, what the frick? I hate his wiggly attack. It's so strong. Oh, shit. I swear I feel like his health is going down slow as shit too. Hate this part. Please don't die. Please don't die. Shit. Oh my gosh, bro. Welcome home, dude. I'm glad you made it home alive. Yeah, this boss fight's pretty good, too. This is a pretty good one. He's messing around with the screen. He's about halfway. We've got him about halfway. He's warbling up the screen with his magic. Ho ho ho. Let's go for a second round. I'm ready. If you'll survive. I hate the warbly notes, dude. I'm so bad with those. Sorry, I can't really read chat much when I'm fighting this guy. It takes a lot of focus. Oh, please don't die now. This is a long ass fight. It takes a while to get this guy killed, but it looks like he's pretty much dead now. Yeah.
Gotcha, green mage, you little bitch. Just in time for about
an hour left of the subathon.
You put on quite a show, Red. It was not the best, but it will do. It will do.
Sayonara, green mage. All that's left is to kill the save point. I'm gonna save first and then kill it.
Good luck.
Very depressing game. I think we killed every single person in Midnight Town. Shit. Except for this save point.
If you kill the save point, you won't be able to save in this location.
Are you really sure you want to kill the save point?
Yeah.
All good things must come to an end. Make sure to finish what you started, friend. Everyone here is liberated. We know it is for a good cause. It's not easy. Go get him, Tiger.
Alright. To the castle we go.
I don't think there's anybody over here, is there? Come here, you little rabbit, you little shit. No.
Hey, Red Hood. We've had our differences. Both of us have had our own goals. Me trying to stop you, you walking all over me and not showing any sympathy. It hurt my feelings, hurt my finances. But right now, my friend, I understand that you're on some sort of killing spree. We can't just let that slide, you know?
This is Everhood, an Undertale-inspired rhythm game, kind of like Undertale Guitar Hero, with multiple endings. Right now we are doing Genocide Route, which requires us to kill every NPC in the whole game. Also the aka the true ending. You have to dodge the notes, deflect them back, and listen to the tunes.
Please, can you just stop? Why bother?
Whoa. He killed me? What the shit? I looked at chat for a second. I got smoked.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Well, welcome to the subathon, man. I'm only streaming as long as chat is making me stream. We're in the middle of a subathon right now, and every sub adds 15 minutes to the clock. Whoa, 2 seconds per bit, sub goals, all that stuff. And yeah, so chat's been making the timer go up higher. We're almost at sub 1 hour, though. Hopefully the end is in sight. Hopefully the end is in sight, my man. Trying to grow here on Twitch, trying to be a great streamer. I hope if anybody's new out there that they would follow. Follows also give 1 minute added to the counter. But welcome. Hope you guys are following. Welcome to the Milky Finishers, man. We're on that grind. We're on that grind set for September. Playing some Everhood Genocide Route right now. Oh, shit.
Well, looks like we're not reaching sub 1 hour yet. Thanks for the sub, man. Thanks for the sub.
How about another 15 minutes, but keep up the hard work.
Thanks, man. Thank you. But, yeah, we're still, looks like we're still floating above the 1 hour mark. More Everhood, I guess. I hate these stupid warbly notes. Trying to whoop this guy's ass. I can't let him make a fool of me. His name is literally Sir Lost a Lot. Yeah, now you're dead. Killed him. Genocide King right here, baby.
Hey, man. You sure are a tough guy.
You little red twerp. Yeah, well, guess what? Now you're in hell. Buttercup. Trying to go to the cursed castle. Finish off the rest of the people. Chad, what did you guys have for dinner? It feels so much later than it is. It feels like it's like midnight. I haven't even eaten dinner yet. But it's like not even 9 p.m. for me, so. What do you guys plan on having? Oh god, it's the ghost. This guy's easy mode. Saturday night, though. You guys happy it's Saturday? How many of you guys were off work, off school, chilling, got the weekend, chilling with the Milky Finishers Milky Subathon? Appreciate it. Boo! Guess my days end here, punk ass. I do feel kind of bad, though. These are nice characters. Work this morning, but you're off tomorrow. Hell yeah, dude. Just in time for a Sunday stream. I can't believe I gotta do another stream already tomorrow. When does Zach Lawley ever get a break? I guess when he dies. Zach Lawley, how do you run 3 YouTube channels, a Discord channel, and live stream on Twitch? Well, lots of depression. Lots of depression. The answer to that one. All by myself. Who the shit is this? Is this Jevil? Who the hell are you?
Hello, little doll. Are you enjoying my creations? I hope you intend to see my next work. It will be more mind-boggling. But hopefully not as tragic. Now go do what you're destined to do.
Who the shit? Who was that guy? I legitimately have never seen that NPC before. I have no idea who the hell that is. What the hell? That was so creepy. I legit don't know who the hell that was. I hate this loud ass guy. Now we gotta fight the two zombies. Let's get him, Zob. So the funny thing is, depending on who you're attacking, the song will play. So when you fight Zob, it plays Zob's song. When you fight Rob, it plays Rob's song. But you fight him at the same time, so the song is constantly switching, and it sounds like shit.
See, every time you attack, it switches the song. It's like so bipolar. I like Zob's song way better than Rob's. Yeah, dude on the left has a much better banger. It's too powerful. I'll take you down, dollface. Damn it. No, he was one hit from death. He was one hit away from dying, bro. I have not played Baldur's Gate 3, but it is on my radar of things that I'm interested in. My backlog has just been so big. I gotta take a bathroom break, though. But we're getting close to sub 1 hour. We're getting closer. But I gotta take a quick bathroom break, kiddos. So feel free to look at the rule. Dude, I can't freaking hit these guys with the thing. There we go. No, I wouldn't say that, bro. I disagree. I love life because I've experienced the good parts of life, man. You gotta search for them, but they're there. It just sucks that I feel like all the best parts of life are a little bit random, you know? All the things that are really, really good seems like it's random. And it doesn't feel like you can actually work to make your life better. Feels like you can try, but at the end of the day, it comes down to the roll of the dice. If that's the way it is, that's the way it is, bro. But also, I don't really trust a lot of people. I've had so many people say, "Oh, I promise this, dude." And guess what? It never matters. At the end of the day, if they don't feel like a minor inconvenience, they won't do shit for you, bro. They'll hide behind all kinds of excuses and act like a little bitch and cry. But at the end of the day, they don't care. They don't care about talking things out. They don't care about being sane or normal. But they'll blame everybody else besides turning the finger on themselves. That's why when it comes to people, bro, use them and lose them. That's my philosophy. Gotcha, guys. Or else they'll do it to you. They'll do it to you, bro. Much appreciated. We're sub 1 hour. We actually broke the sub 1 hour. We were getting close a couple times, but we're actually less than an hour before the ending. Oh no, not well, never mind. Oh no. Oh god, why did I say that, dude? I was actually feeling hope. But hey, you know what? 51 subs is 51 subs, bro. I ain't gay, but 51 subs is 51 subs. And take out my exhaustion on these assholes. You can't come here and cause a ruckus. I don't like the vibes you're putting out, man. Someone should teach you a thing or two about bad behavior. You think that qualifies us to help, Muck? You're darn right, Flan. Don't go easy on you, kid. I'm a cold-blooded killer. You think I care? Oh, I forgot my controller battery's dying. This is actually one of the saddest fights in the game, to me. I don't know why. I mean, I do know why, but like, these two hillbillies are kind of goofy, but this fight actually kind of makes me a little sad. You'll see why in a second here. This is why. So you kill his brother first, and look at his face. He just gets so mad because he loves his brother, and now he goes. He kind of like loses it and goes apeshit. And now the fight's actually hard. I will make you pay. The wrath of a brother. Luckily, you forgot that I'm cracked at this game, and nothing can stop me. Not even, like, 9 hours into live streaming. Jamming out to the tunes. Shit, dude. Fuck.
Sayonara, buddy.
Now you can join your brother in hell. I won't stop till you're dead. Well, too bad. You horrible creature. I hate you. Wow, what an uplifting, happy-go-lucky freaking game this is, man. You guys ready for one of my favorite moments in the game? This is like such an Undertale moment, but I love it. I don't care. It's so stupid, but I love it. When I first saw this, it blew my mind. It says, do you want to stop killing? No.
It's the cursor, bro!
I admire your determination, but I can't stand the choices that you're making. I can't be a part of this murderous crusade. One of our quests must end now.
Literally, the in-game cursor's like, bro, you're killing too many people, bro. I gotta stop you. Dude, I love that. The in-game cursor is like, yeah, bro, you're taking it too far. Now I gotta kill you. You literally fight the menu.
He's kind of cracked, too. Like I said, I don't know if I've ever played a game that's as underrated as this, dude. There's no reason why this shouldn't be, like, super popular. It's got everything. Multiple endings, fun gameplay, banger soundtrack, cheap indie darling. This game is like the Milky Finisher is the game. Underrated. Maybe that's why I like it so much. Wait, did you just gift another sub? Or was that before? Oh, that was before. Okay, thank God. I don't know why my Twitch like refresh or my chat like refreshed. So like looked like it moved, and then I looked and I was like, wait, that doesn't seem right. Dude, relax. How much life could you possibly have? No! Okay. Never mind, I got him. I thought the song ended, I lost. Suck on that cursor! Hoo-ha!
The cursor is now dead.
So, now that the cursor's dead, look what happens if you talk to anybody or open up the menu. Like, let's talk to Purple Mage right now. Look it. You'll see. Now the text is red, and instead of the cursor, it's replaced with your wooden hand. It's the doll's hand, so now it's you. Oh, you can't really see it. Let me go full screen here. Yeah, so now the text is red, and it's Red's hand, the wooden hand, instead of the cursor for the rest of the game, now that you've killed the cursor. Crazy.
For many years, I have been told that this mirror tells you the truth. I have spent many nights thinking on this. If you have any decency left, I urge you to leave. Just stop this act and leave. You are not a killer. Refund this game if you can. Just leave us alone.
Damn, dude. Fourth wall breaking. They're just like, if you have any decency left in you, refund the game, shut it down, stop. Stop killing. But we've come too far to stop now, Chad. We've come too far to stop the genocide route. So you've come here to kill me. Maybe this was meant to be. Although, I won't give up my life easily. I like the animations on Purple's cloak. Whoops, I screwed that up majorly. Come on, bro, it's so hard to land a hit. This is why I hate Purple, because every time she hits you, you go back in time and, like, it heals her. A very frustrating boss. But it is a lot less frustrating when you have to kill her because you have the arm, which helps you do counters. As opposed to, like, the first time you fight her, which you have to just only dodge. From the pacifist version of the fight.
Sayonara, Purple.
I don't think there's any women left. I think we've killed all two women that are in this whole game.
This is how it ends. You fought well. I never stood a chance.
Later, skater. Now we gotta go to the bubblegum land. Oh yeah, we gotta kill the spider. Wait, what is this shit? I've never seen this before. Hold up, what the hell? What the hell? Wait a second, I've never seen this. No! That's all we get? What does that mean? Bro, what does that mean? I want more! Bro, I want more. D-
damn. There's apparently more to this game than I realized. I still have never gotten the epilogue ending either. Because the boss fight's just way too hard. I literally played for like 5 hours. I could not beat the damn boss. I played for 5 hours and couldn't even get halfway. That's how hard the secret epilogue boss is. It's been quite a journey, hasn't it? I'm rooting for you, Red. Yeah, now you're dead. If you find pink spirits, an old saying says not to trust them. They are known to be quite mischievous. Thanks for the advice. I guess this is as good as any place to die. It's cold and comfortable. Where would you like to die? I want to go back to that car accident world. I want to know what's going on with the car accident world. I'm trying to find the spooky spider, but I think he's running away from me. In the pacifist version, he attacks you, and this, you are the prey. And he is your... No, you're the predator, and he's the prey. Yeah, come here, you little shit. You better run. Gotcha, buddy. Dude, he attacks so difficultly. Holy shit! Take that, big ass spider.
I failed, Master Goldpig!
Looks like Spider Boy's blasting off again. Now we can follow the pink spirits to the hidden bubblegum land. Thank you.
What do you want to do?
Hello, Red. Keep following the candy canes and you'll arrive at Bubblegum Land.
Yeah, bullshit.
You sure pack a punch?
Dead. We just killed the Bubblegum Man. So pretty much, after listening to Nosferatu, who's like, don't listen to pink spirits, they lie to you. That's pretty much true. If you follow the candy canes, you'll be on an infinite loop. You'll never leave. You'll just be walking around aimlessly. So you have to actually go the opposite way if you want to progress. Because the bubblegum spirits lie to you. So the only way to actually progress is to go back the way you came. Because if you keep following the candy canes, it's just going to loop forever. It is, dude. It's awesome. What's going on, Marco? Welcome to the subathon, bro. I am freaking tired. I've been live for 9 hours. We're playing Everhood. We're doing Genocide Route. Yeah, well, that's what happens when you do a subathon, bro. I'm tired as shit. Here's all the rules. And yeah, we're currently doing... We did so much today. We played Tears of the Kingdom. We beat an entire Mario mod where we escaped from jail. We fist-fought Sonic the Hedgehog. Super Sonic. We fist-fought him. And what else did we play? Is that it? I don't even remember. Dude. My brain is fried. But that is the rules. I know. We were talking about that. Only 49 minutes to go, though. 49 minutes to go. Yep, we were talking about no Tears of the Kingdom DLC, and we were talking about no, or the Switch 2 rumors. Crazy stuff with Nintendo. Crazy, crazy Nintendo news lately. Ugh. But yeah, this is a cool game that we're playing now. It's inspired by Undertale. Wait, there's Smash Bros. Rumors? What the hell? Are there really? Bro, there's no way. Anyway, let's kill the bubblegum people.
Welcome to Bubblegum Land. Relax and rest.
Yeah, you rest in hell, kid.
Oh, why do a job badly when you can do it well? It sure is good to be a bubblegum entity. Welcome to Bubblegum Land.
Kill. What are the Smash rumors, though? I haven't heard this. There's so many rumors. Just tell me. I want to know. Fill me in. Chat has been talking about rumors all day. They're like, oh yeah, there's going to be a new F-Zero. There's going to be a new Donkey Kong game. There's going to be Metroid Prime 4. Like, every September, we get Nintendo rumors up the wangzoo. I remember last year, they were going to be like, they're going to add GameCube to NSO. It was like, bull corn.
The quest is so big.
Damn, look at this big bubblegum guy.
Hello, Red. By now, you should have come across the powers you wield. Only you can erase the inhabitants of this realm. It is an incredible power which only you possess. Some life is supposed to extend into centuries, while others are shorter. If one is in a loop where they cannot die and yet they fear death, that is not a pleasant way to live. That is why. You, as the human, have a gift. You get to experience the world within all its dualities, unfairness, and chaos, with an expiration date that someday this will all end. It is truly the most bittersweet feature of your existence. I give you only my words of advice. You are doing this for a cause that is good. Do what you think is right. If you do not agree, then who is to stop a god of death? Much has been said. We must go on.
Interesting. Yeah, could you imagine? I mean, honestly, with how
Mario Kart, like Mario Kart got DLC like 10 years after the game, if Sakurai came back and said, hey, Fighters Pass 3, 5 new characters for the next 2 years, here we go, I would not be that shocked. Really, I wouldn't. If he just came out of retirement and said, hey, new Fighters Pass 3 pre-order now, here's the first character, 4 more coming out till the end of 2024, mid-2025 or something, I would be like, holy shit, but I wouldn't. It doesn't seem like copium. It seems like hopium, but it doesn't seem like the most impossible thing. I've heard more impossible things. Like, if you were to go back a year and tell me that there was going to be a full HD from the ground up remake of Mario RPG, I would have told you that I thought that was way more impossible than Fighters Pass 3. I don't think there's like no chance we're gonna get a new Smash Brothers, but Fighters Pass 3 is possible. Like I said, probably not a new game for many years, but Fighters Pass 3, 5 more characters in development, that is a lot more doable. Reinvigorate that franchise, or that series right now. Oh my god, dude, Gino, holy shit, now you're getting me hyped. Now I'm all hyped up for shit that's not gonna happen again. Alright, let's kill Gold Pig. He's the one that started off this whole story. So you found my backup secret hideout. Now that you found me, what are you gonna do? You gonna finish me off because I took your arm? Or are you gonna stroll out where you came from? Kill. So you're here to erase my existence. You've destroyed my empire. You've ruined my reputation. You've forced me to flee for my life. Yet your thirst to kill does not end. Only because I took your arm? You disgust me. If it's my life you want, I won't give it away easily. I will make you walk through hell. This is Everhood. Our full playthrough's up on YouTube on the Milky Archives if you ever want to catch up. It is an Undertale-inspired musical RPG. Multiple endings, secret bosses, and it's all like Guitar Hero combat. Like, this is the boss fights. You dodge musical notes, send them back at the boss. Super underrated game. One of the most underrated video games I've ever played. Definitely deserves more attention. A really good story too. Good story, good music, good fights, characters. Awesome game. I think I failed this one though because you have to kill him in a time limit and I think that I screwed up, but I'll try to kill him anyways. Oh my god, I suck. Monster. I am powerless to do anything. Why won't you die? Right now we're doing genocide route, which is actually the true ending, which is cool for a change. Yeah, Pink. Yeah, I just don't know why. I don't know why Pink was
in the traffic thing. And this is, I've beaten both pacifist and genocide route for this game, and I still don't know what the hell that was about. I mean, I have a couple ideas, but I've never seen that before. I don't know what triggered that or what that really meant.
Dude, he was so close to dying, I'm pissed.
Is that all you got? How disappointing. Yeah, shut up. I hate the bosses that are timed. I like the ones that loop. Like, if you fail, you loop till you kill them. The ones that are timed, it's like, you gotta be, like, perfect. But again, like I said, I'm playing on hard mode. You gotta be, like, super aggressive. Like, just constantly wailing on him. Like, I'm doing a lot better now. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting that there's low battery, but I'll live. Dude, I hate when I can't hit the guy and it deflects my attack like that. There we go. I'm doing a lot better now. His health is a lot lower. But yeah, this game was only $8 on sale on Switch, dude. It was such a good... What a steal. One of my favorite games. I've done multiple playthroughs, and there's still so much. There's so many secret bosses and endings, and $8, dude. Awesome. Awesome deal. I think normally it's $25, but I got it on sale. It's either $20 or $25. Either way, it's worth it. I've paid $60 for games that are not as good as this. Did I really lose again? Okay. Or do I still have time? He's like two hits away from death, please. Okay, here we go. Fuck. Quit deflecting my shit, bro. Oh, thank God. Holy shit. There's no physical. It's on Steam and NS, not NSO, Steam and Switch, digital only. There was no physical release for this game. Because like I said, it's only a $20 game. It's either $20 or $25, I can't remember, but it was on sale for $8, I had to get it. You put on quite a show, you annoying wooden doll. Haha, you have bested me. I wish thousands and millions of years of torment upon you. You piece of... He dies. The Bubblegum Land Massacre. 7 people left. Only 7 souls remain before we have genocided everybody in Everhood. It's been a long road. I feel like we killed a shit ton of people. There's only 7 left. Get me the hell out of here. Thank you. Now we gotta go up the tower again. I think we've killed everybody in the castle. I think there's just the carnival and the forest left. I think we've killed everybody besides the people at the carnival and the people in the forest. The doors let you know if you've killed everybody in an area. Plus we have the lantern that if you stand still, the paw prints will show up and show you where there's someone to go. Or show you where there's like someone to kill.
I am free again, thanks to you. The mages locked me up. Your work here is done.
Yeah, I think we'll save here. And I can probably finish this game in one more part. Finish this game in one more episode. We did a lot. Including my favorite boss fight, the flower shop. Not my favorite, but one of my favorite, the flower shop guy.
Good luck with whatever you're doing.
Minutes left of the subathon, guys. 34 minutes left. I'm really hungry and I want to eat dinner. So if anybody extended the stream, I'd have to take a quick 10-minute break anyways to eat.